nation here in Japan. This state guest house is where Mr. President's mother, then President Corazon Aquino, stayed during her state visit to Japan back in 1986. And it is certainly a great pleasure for me to welcome President Aquino as our state guest here at the same place. 2 years ago, when I visited the Philippines, I had the first-hand experience of the real, world famous Filipino hospitality by receiving heartwarming welcome. I would like to once again express my appreciation. Today, we are honored to have the presence of prominent leaders from political circles and business community, as well as intellectuals whom we invited to this banquet. All of you have made tremendous contribution to strengthening friendship and cooperation between Japan and the Philippines. Taking this opportunity, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude. President Aquino, I was extremely moved and impressed by your speech at the Diet yesterday. And I believe many of my fellow members of the Japanese Diet shared this excitement and also the sense of inspiration. At the very beginning of the summit meeting that we just had, I referred to Mr. President's speech as the out-of-the-park home run. But I understand that baseball is less popular in the Philippines. Actually, basketball is a lot more popular in the Philippines, so I should say the speech was a slam dunk. Mr. President articulated support for Japan's path as a peace-loving nation, and also Japan's policy of proactive contribution to peace based on the principle of international cooperation, as well as our growth strategy. I am truly, truly grateful for that. We just had the sixth summit meeting. It was a really meaningful meeting where both of us confirmed our intention to strengthen our bilateral relations in every field. Japan and the Philippines have been cherishing an extremely robust friendship through consistent and strenuous efforts for the past 70 years. During the course of this history, many Japanese, such as aid workers and business people, have contributed to the nation-building efforts in the Philippines, soaked in sweat.
2 years
ago, when Typhoon Haiyan hit the Philippines, more than 1,000 members of the Japanese self-defense forces were dispatched for their activities on the ground. In addition, many Japanese, including today's guests and participants, offered support. Back then, the Facebook account of Japan's Prime Minister's office received a record-breaking number of likes and also thank you notes from the Filipino people in every corner of the world. Next year, Japan and the Philippines will mark the 60th anniversary of the diplomatic relations. In concluding my welcome remarks, I would like to express my wishes of good health and happiness to President Aquino and everyone here. I also like to pray that our bilateral relations will further develop as we move forward. Thank you.
Thank you. おめでとうございます今日は。
Reconstruction and Development, and through your International Development Agency,
as a matter of obligations arising from the tragedies of the past. Ours is a strategic partnership bound by a shared affinity for mutual advancement, democracy, freedom, equality, and the rule of law. Our bond has fostered in us a confidence that we can rely on each other in building a better, more peaceful, and more stable future for our peoples, our region, and the rest of the community. Mr. Prime Minister, in the region they come from, there is a dialect which I speak called Kapampangan. Coincidentally, in Kapampangan, the word Abe means friend. I must say you have been a true Abe to me and to my people. I consider you a kindred spirit, and my countrymen and I wish you even greater success. We are also truly grateful for the friendship of the Japanese people, who, like my countrymen, have questioned the status quo for the better, thereby granting us the promise of an even stronger, deeper, and better relationship, one that enables us to more effectively address the challenges